or greatest example that we have. If you want to know exactly what the meaning of لتسكنوا إليها between two spouses, go back, read carefully how did السيدة خديجة رضي الله تعالى عنها took care of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم when he was under that significant pressure from everyone, you know, all direction, you know, and how was she رضي الله تعالى عنها وأرضاها handling this matter at home just to make the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم feel peaceful at home, you know, and everyone supporting. And this not by chance, you know, this even was mentioned in Quran. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked Zammiluni, and it was narrated, revealed in Quran, أيها المزمل, just to show you how high and sophisticated was this relation, you know, of Sakina between the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and Sayyidah Khadija رضي الله عنها. We may not be able, you know, to work as such, you know, or, but just, we should have this as a simple or standard, or let's put it in this way, better understanding to us, you know, about what's meant in this ayah when the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. Okay? I cannot imagine anything, you know, which higher or more sophisticated than this relation, this unique relation between Sayyidah Khadija رضي الله تعالى عنها with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم at that time, you know, and no doubt that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was under tremendous pressure, you know, from everywhere, you know, at that time, and how is going to get the relief by Sayyidah Khadija رضي الله تعالى inside his house. And if we are real followers of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, we should provide this service at our home, at home, okay? This is our task. We should provide this service. Don't wait for the other one to initiate it. You should initiate it, okay? Regardless of what you are going to have as a benefit from that, okay? And that's what Sayyidah Khadija did. يعني when you read what she had done, you feel as if this woman is not expecting or waiting for anything. Just out of her duty, she is doing what she should do, you know, at that time, without looking at her wealth, which has been gone away, you know, because of this or that, you know, or her rest or whatever, you know, all that. يعني she is sacrificing everything just to make it peaceful to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم at home. How great is this thing? Okay? And for sure she has a lot of hope in Allah. Raja, very great raja in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But in her practice, she was not looking to get anything back as a benefit of what she is doing. And as a matter of fact, when you look at, as I mentioned yesterday about those companions who passed away before the fruits of Islam started to show up, and this for sure includes Sayyidah Khadija radiallahu anha, because she passed away in the most critical point, you know, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was still in Mecca al-Mukarramah, you know, under that repression and pressure and whatever, you know, you name it, you know. For sure she passed away without, in the apparent side, getting any of the benefit or fruit of what she has done back to her. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave her good tidings, bishara, about baiting. You see, this is the first time I understand it. Now why I'm speaking, you know, with you. Why did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ببيت المقصب لا صخب فيه ولا نصب, no cries or shouting or screaming, ولا نصب, no to get tired, you know, or get highly, يعني, active towards something, you know. لا صخب فيه ولا نصب. Why Sayyidah Khadija was rewarded with such a home in the paradise. This is a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because she arranged and managed in her, at her home, to make it for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he is going to face outside sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all types of sahab and nasab. See, she managed to make it inside without sahab. See how great is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He rewarded her with the same thing she was looking for to have for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not for herself, you know. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted her with this. See, yeah, for anyone may say, so what, يعني, in Jannah you are not going to have sahab and nasab. Why this word has been mentioned? This word has been mentioned specifically in this setting because this is the way Sayyidina Khadija managed in this life. And this should be the aim not only for women, you know, also for men to aim at, because even the women, they are in real need of having sakina at home. يعني the woman, the wife, if she has her husband, you know, coming at home, you know, shouting and say, what is this table is put here and what you have cooked tonight and oh my God. She's going to feel the war started whenever he entered house, and peace started whenever he leave, right? So that's why we are in real need in both directions. It's not the need of the man only, you know, to have it whenever he returns back. Even the woman, she should feel a great feeling about the presence of her man, you know, at home. Not to just wish that he's outside and all the time. Just go and be busy with your friends, you know, and go to this area and that area, and don't come home, please. How do you feel about this? Is this going to strengthen the relation or not? Another way of expressing that, يتسكنوا إليها. This is perhaps, يعني, I encourage you to read carefully about what I'm telling you, okay? Especially the Sayyidina Khadija, what she has done, you know, how did she deal with the Prophet, how did she describe the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how